Are you using time tracking, or did you ever want to round to the next 15-minute interval? Then this video is for you. Hey, my name is Manuel Gig. I'm the founder of Techflow AI, and in this video, I will show you exactly how you can use Integromat, Integromat functions, and automation in general to round to the next 15 minutes interval from a specific time. So it will always like round to the next 15 minute value, either round up or round down. And how it looks like, I will show you in a second. So we have this example time, it's 8:55. And if I run this once, then the output will look like this. So it will round to the next 15 minute interval, which is 9 o'clock in this case, just for demonstration purposes that this is actually working. So if it's 8:47 and I run this again, it will round it down to 8:45. And if I try just another value for demonstration purposes, for example, 8:35, then it will round it to 8:30. So it's always rounding up or down depending on what is closer to the next 15 minute interval. And how it looks like, the whole magic, it's this one. Yeah, it looks kind of weird, but I get that. And no worries, we will go through it step by step on how to set this all up. It looks super confusing, but I will show you exactly how it works. Let's get into the individual steps and try to break this formula down into individual parts. So we have this example time, we get minutes. We update this one first. So we get the minutes, then we do some calculations, which are in these three tool blocks, and then we set the new time to make it actually work. So in this case, we have 8:55 and the output is 9 o'clock. Now let's get into the setup of the individual modules. These are just variable modules, so you can use that directly, like the formula that I showed. You can use it directly inside a module that where you want to output the new time or the new duration, and that is super helpful for that. So let's get through the individual formulas. First is just setting the time. Then the second one is getting the minutes from that time. So we want to first parse the date to get the actual timestamp. Then we parse it by lowercase h and then colon and mm. This is the code for the time am pm. So you can look that up if you go to Integromat date time formatting, which is this one over here. So I will link this in the description below this video and you can directly access it. And this will show you all the parameters that you can use for formatting date and time. And we use this one. So the 12 hour time frame, lowercase h. It would actually make more sense to use the uppercase h in this case because I'm not using am and pm, but for demonstration purposes, that is more than enough. And then we use mm for minutes with leading zero. So that is what we're using here. Going back into it, we parse the date, so we get the timestamp first, and then we format the date to get only the minutes out because that is what we want to work with, right? So now once we got the minutes, we are having the 55 minutes, so it's 8:55, and now we're getting just the minutes. Now we do a calculation, which is minutes and then modulus 15. This basically will divide minutes by 15 and then give out the rest that is left over. So if you divide it by 15, like the next one would be 45, because 45, and then 30, then 15, and then 0. So 45, and then the difference of 55 to 45 is 10, and this is what this one outputs. So the difference to the next 15 minutes equivalent, if you round it down, is 10. Now the next one, we want to round this, so we get the rest, so the 10. We divide it by 15, and then we round it. The reason for this is that we want to know if we have to round it up or round it down. So if the like upper 15 minutes interval is closer to the lower one, and that is what this is basically doing. So we divide it by 15 and then we round it. So if it's 0.5, it will round it up. So it will be 1, the output of this one. And if it's lower than 0.5, it will round it down, which means if the output here is 15, for example, it will be divided by 15 and then it's 1. If it is 10, it will be divided by 15 and that is bigger than 0.5, which means it will round it up because it's closer to the next 15 minute interval. And if it's 7, for example, that's almost the middle. So if you divide it by 15, it will be 0.5. 5 something maybe. So it will still round it up, but if it's 6, then it will round it down. No, actually it's 0.4 something, so it will already round it down if you just have a difference of 7 minutes. Then this formula outputs either 1 or 0, because we're just rounding it, so it outputs 1 or 0. And then the next formula actually takes this 1 and 0 and has an if, a later if function and a sum function. So we're first checking if the output of this one is 1. And if it is 1, then we want to round it up. And if it is 0, then we want to round it down, because like the lower 50 minute interval is closer to our time. For the if function, if you hover over any function, you will get help, like how the function works. So it expects an expression first, and then a, like after the first semicolon, it will put the value that will be input there if the expression is true. And if the expression is not true, it will input or output value b. So that is what we are using here. We layer a sum function in between, so we get or we sum the minutes that we had before, so the 55, and then we're using 15 minus the rest if it is 1, so that is our A part here up to this part. So we use 15 minus the rest and add that to the actual minutes. So that is when we want to round it up, because 15 minus the rest will be like the next 15 minute interval. And then for B, if it's not equal to 1, which means we want to round it down, then we use the minutes and just subtract the rest from it. So the rest that we got out here, so we use the minutes, which is 55, and then subtract 10 from it, and then it would be 45. And that is our new 15 minute interval that we will need. So the output of this one, since we have a 1 here, it will use the first part, so sum minutes, and then 15 minus the rest. So the rest is 10, 15 minus the rest is 5. And then it sums up the minutes plus this function here, and that will be 55 plus 5, so it's 60, and the output is 60. So that is like the new time that we want to round to if we want to have 15 minute intervals. And now we can check the output. So the final output, or like we set the time, the new time. We do this pretty similar, like we parse the time at the very beginning. So we parse the time first, the original time, with the h and then colon double m. Then we use the function setMinute, where we set the minute of the time, only the minutes, to a specific time that we just created here, that we just calculated. So we set the time to the final time, and then we format the time, or the format the date again, to h and then colon mm. And that is what it outputs. So it outputs 9:00, even so, though the minutes have been 60, but it automatically calculates the hours, so it automatically formats it correctly if you add more than 60 minutes. Yep, this is the whole magic. Then just combine this all into one formula. This is how it looks like. This is everything inside one text field layered. And if you like this video, hit the like and subscribe button and leave a comment below, and that would be super helpful. And if you want to learn more about Integromat functions, I've got an Integromat functions with more than 45 pages of explanations of these functions, how they work, how you can use them. And as you can see, they're super powerful once you've mastered them, and you can use them anywhere in any text field inside Integromat, and they will save you a lot of operations. Thank you very much for watching the video. Stay tuned for more and subscribe to my channel.